reason why Nigeria is also treated harshly is because they have oil. Oil is a world, maybe with the coming of electric cars, we will see it. But it's a resource that the world is looking for, and they would go to no ends to get it, whether they have their own desires or they don't. So that is part of the reason. Anyway, going back to this young author of Nigeria called Chimamanda, she's on BET. She has a presentation called The Single Line Story. Each and every person owes a duty to do it. For Botswana, there is a Professor Scott Bueller from Denver with A Tale of Two Countries. That it's also a must-see. It's on YouTube because it happens. As I mentioned, PEPFAR, we couldn't in Botswana have managed HIV/AIDS without our American partners. We got our independence in 1966. In 1967, we opened an embassy in Washington. So we model our democracy and try to take the good of it out of the American system. But our Botswana democracy, it's a homebrewed democracy. Because since the British didn't do anything to us, we left off our culture what we thought was good, including consensus building, including listening to people, even if they are varying with you. That bred the tolerance. And when we then crafted our constitution, talking of the various freedoms of speech, freedom of assembly, it was because it was also part of our country. So that's why our democracy is what it is. Do you know the story of a starfish? I think it must be on YouTube, I'm not sure. The starfish was dying all over, and it was millions and billions of them. And a man picks one starfish, throws it back in the water, and says that one would survive. You see this huge population of Nigeria and you feel helpless, but that one starfish that you will pick will make a difference and will multiply to proportions that you never thought you would imagine. I do not want to hear any African saying, I don't want to get into politics. There is family politics, there is church, even the church, my church where I go to in Botswana, there's church politics. A new priest comes in and there are certain deacons who don't want him. That's church politics. There's family politics. I have three children, but I know that if I want to get a particular project going and moving, I have to talk to this one, she would influence the others. It's family politics. Here at the university, there's university politics. There's a new dean, there's a new president, there's a new provost. Listen to the lecturers. Politics is part of our lives. We cannot contract out of. And when the educated want to make money, because in Botswana, at least in politics, there's no money, we need to start paying our politicians so that when people dangle carrots before them, they resist. But we also need to start having educated politicians. If you're going to sit in your nice air-conditioned offices and let uneducated people like myself make up decisions, we are going to mess up the countries and your future for your children and for the future generations. All of us must be involved. If we are going to succeed, we need to go back and say on AIDS, let our NACA visit the Botswana NACA. Let learn what they are doing. Nowadays, they don't even need to go there. You know, this technology, let's teleconference with them. Let's talk to them and make appointment, and we would have a 2-hour meeting, and we are in Lagos and they are in Botswana. What people missed out of the so-called Arab Spring, and even now what is happening in Ukraine, is the use of technology to communicate. And when you talk about our teledensity, yourselves in Nigeria, you even carry cell phones which have diamonds, even though you don't have diamonds. So these phones must start to be used as a technology tool so that we are able to go over quite a lot of problems, because all the cell phones we don't produce. So we are continuing to enrich, but at least let us benefit from the technologies which come out of that. So my advice is go there, let the media be involved. Media, public, private. When we talk about a sketch, everybody, it's not about politics, it's not about members of opposition. It has to be a nation strategy. It has to be all the parties to be brought on board with consensus so that in the war it's fought from one front.
Thank you. I see no questions. Do you have questions of us?
Yes, I do. Thank you very much for asking. We are currently in Botswana heading a University of Science and Technology. It's called BUIST, B-U-I-S-T, Botswana University of Science and Technology. It's at its teething stages. It is headed by a Nigerian-American professor. And we are looking for partnerships. We are looking for excellence. We would like to see you taking your students to Botswana. We would like to see partnerships developing between our country and our institutions. When an African or a European or whoever, a traveler, let them not have a name, comes to the US, they want to see New York, they want to see Washington, they want to see where government is, and then they want to see where trade is. Well, you can then include North Carolina, you can include your Chicago's and others. But those two, if all they had was 3 days or 4 days in the States, they want to see it. Botswana is the New York of Africa. We want it to be seen, because the news never brings good news. So all these things that I'm saying, I'm not saying we don't have challenges, but all these things that I'm saying, if very educated people in the US don't know them, and they don't know them because there is no action happening, what is happening is good news. So the question would be, why always go where the bad news is? Why not go to a good news country so that the good news can be told and can be shared? Or that where there are problems at the good news, they are uplifted to be perfected. So we are happy with President Obama because for the first time we are going to have a summit where he's calling all the African leaders to come and dialogue. Out of the 10 fastest growing nations of the world, 6 of those are in Africa. We speak English like you do. We we may speak it with an accent, but at least we can hear what we are saying. We don't speak any Chinese. How have the Chinese found it easy to go into Africa and the Americans are not finding it easy when we do the same language? Almost all countries of Africa have an American embassy there. When I was a student here 40 years ago, I used to be asked, you people in Africa, do you stay on trees? And I used to say, yes, we stay on trees, and we have given the American ambassador the tallest of the trees so that he can see us there from the top. Of course, that was just in jest. But what I was trying to say is, if an American ambassador can survive in Botswana, what about all the other people? So this partnership, my generation, is a lost generation. I put an X on my generation. But these ones, who are not afraid to go to Botswana and go and live in the village like Molekolole, that's where we need to pin our hopes on our youth, to make our youth communicate with the youth, not just of Botswana, of the world, because we need to bring up a global citizen. And a global citizen is the one who can stay and pay for themselves in a six-star hotel, but who can also go to Molekolole and eat what the people in Molekolole are eating and know that nothing will happen to them. So the university must continue to play the role of exposing the students to the globe, to China, even with its inefficiencies, to Nigeria, even with its corruptions, because it's only when they go there that they can make a change. Some of the businesses, if they go to China, they will make more money than they make in the US, because the factors of production are cheap. We are starting an innovation hub. We just came from the headquarters of the technology. We want to invite all the companies to go and help us in. And in the process, become a win-win. Africa is now talking about trade. It's not talking so much about aid. There are a few African countries, LDCs, who are still talking about aid. But the majority of them, because we are so-called middle income or high income, we are talking about this window. To send a student from this university to any of the African countries, it's a plus for that student. And they will become a leader. So this is why I am so glad that half of the people here are students. I wish I was speaking to all the students in an auditorium, but I know it is not possible with the classes. But any day that you could have something like that, I'll come running from Washington.
We'd be thrilled if you would. You don't have to run.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thanks.